a conceptual model for diffusion of socio-environmental innovation in the RENDRUS network based on caste perspective. According to Sayama, the various modeling approaches can be put into the following major families. Descriptive modeling. In this approach, modelers try to specify the state of a system at macro level at a given time point, capturing what the system looks like. This can be done taking a picture, creating prototypes such as physical models or using quantitative methods such as statistic models. Rule-based modeling. In this approach, modelers try to come up with dynamical rules at micro level that explain the observed macro behavior of a system. The modeling methodologies mainly used are cellular automata, network models, agent-based models and dynamical equations. Caste perspective concerns with elements called agents that learn or adapt in response to rule-based nonlinear interactions with other agents generating the behavior and the hierarchical structure of a caste. Particular combinations of agents at one level become agents at the next level up. As the results of the nonlinear interactions, the agents are able to cooperate and evolve, improving in certain cases their fitness over time. In the mid-1990s, the ABMS computational approach was recognized by Holland as a foundational methodology to the study of caste. ABMS is a form of computational modeling whereby a phenomenon is modeled in terms of agents and their interactions using the bottom-up perspective in the sense that the system behavior that we observe in the model emerges from the bottom of the system by the direct interrelations of the agents from the basis of the model. So, it is possible to understand the simple interaction rules between agents at local level. The definition of a space scale is fundamental in ABMS, while the time scale varies in discrete steps. From the computational perspective, the software that is used to program agents has its origins in the areas of artificial intelligence, especially in the subfield of distributed artificial intelligence, whose objective is the study of agents' properties and the design of networks of interaction between them. It was suggested by Woolridge and Jennings that computational agents are typically characterized as follows. Autonomy, the agents had direct control of their actions and their internal state. Social skills, the agents interacted with other agents through a computational language. Reaction, agents were able to perceive their environment and respond to it. The environment could be the physical world, a virtual world or a simulated world that includes other agents. Proactivity, because the agents reacted to their environment, they themselves had to take the goal-oriented initiative. In general, the environment of agents is interpreted in terms of a metaphorical vocabulary of beliefs, desires, motives and emotions, which are generally applied more in the description of people. The agent's attributes typically modeled are knowledge and beliefs, inferences, social models, representation of knowledge, goals, planning, language and emotions. According to McCall and North, an agent-based model contains the following four elements, C. A network of elements in a typical agent-based model. Agents, their attributes and environment. Relationships between agents and the rules of interaction. A connectivity network that defines how and with whom agents interact. Agents' environment that interacts with agents, interchanging information. The RENDRUS network conceptualized as a caste presents the following characteristics, C. The conceptual model of the RENDRUS network based on caste approach. Multiple key heterogeneous agents. Small rural producers and their organizations, governmental institutions, academic institutions and the knowledge society. Different structural levels. At micro level, the RENDRUS network is constituted by rural producers interacting with one another, and with governmental and academic institutions, while at macro level, the collaborative learning emerges for leading to the autonomy of rural producers and the structural transformations, which are reflected in the collective benefit. Intrinsic diversity among its key agents. Small producers from the 32 Mexican federal states are product of the exposure of their own experiences within a socioeconomic, cultural and environmental context. So, the incorporation and adoption of new socio-environmental innovations, in order to establish areas for improvement in productive, organizational and business processes, are determined by local requirements. Functional dynamics. The RENDRUS network is an open system that exchanges relevant information containing producers' experiences with a complex environment. In order to survive, increasing the participation of rural producers and governmental and academic institutions, the RENDRUS network has to adapt itself to new conditions imposed by the environment, adjusting its functional units through the modification and selection of new socio-environmental innovations. The impact of the social structure. The interactions between members of the RENDRUS network are not random but are rather limited by social networks, both internally and externally. The social structure and socio-cultural interactions between members have a crucial effect on the process of evolution of the adoption of socio-environmental innovations. In this case, the principle of the social structure is based on the community. The diffusion in the RENDRUS network is the process by which socio-environmental innovation is communicated through certain channels, meetings, internet, etc., over time among rural producers and their organizations, governmental institutions and academic institutions. In this case, when new answers to complex problems regarding sustainable rural development emerge from the interactions between rural producers and governmental and academic institutions and these are diffused and adopted or rejected by rural producers, some alterations occur at functional and structural level of the RENDRUS network, originating a social change due to the activation of peer networks about such socio-environmental innovation in the next four areas: transformation of primary, agricultural and livestock production, rural industry and marketing, rural non-agricultural services and handicrafts, and rural extension. Following graph, we present the five attributes of socio-environmental innovations of the RENDRUS network as follows. Relative advantage. The degree to which rural producers perceive the socio-environmental innovation as being better than the practice it supersedes. The exchange of innovation evaluation information between rural producers of the RENDRUS network, using the communication network, lies the diffusion process. Compatibility. The degree to which the socio-environmental innovation is perceived by rural producers as consistent with the existing socio-cultural values, past experiences and specific needs of potential adopters. Complexity. The degree to which rural producers perceive the socio-environmental innovation is relatively difficult to understand and use. Trialability. The degree to which the socio-environmental innovation may be experimented with on a limited basis. Observability. The degree to which the results of the socio-environmental innovation are visible to other rural producers. In summary, socio-environmental innovations of the RENDRUS network that are perceived as relatively advantageous, compatible with existing socio-cultural values, beliefs and experiences, relatively easy to adapt, observable and divisible for trial, will be adopted more rapidly by rural producers. As discussed by Bass, in the literature, two models for how innovations diffuse through social systems are recognized, endogenous and exogenous. On the one hand, in the endogenous diffusion model, how fast an innovation spreads is a function of its own popularity between the members of the social system. Following graph, in this case the proportion of the social system that has adopted the innovation over time starts out slow, slowly builds to a critical mass, where it achieves exponential growth, and finally levels off as it saturates the social system. The model, as seen in, is a bell-shaped curve that shows the data about the general endogenous diffusion process on a frequency basis, whereas the S-shaped curve shows the same data on a cumulative basis. On the other hand, in the exogenous diffusion model, potential adopters respond directly to exogenous effects. The endogenous diffusion model of an innovation over time by members of a social system, adopted from REF. From the CAS perspective, both variety and reactivity are necessary for the diffusion of an innovation. Variety refers to the diverse population for emergence and adaptation and it is necessary for information exchange that takes place between an innovation sender and an innovation receiver, whereas reactivity refers to the sensitivity to change where only those populations with adaptability to change can survive at the higher fitness thresholds that occur during cascading mutation/extinction. The information exchange between an innovation sender and an innovation receiver is a critical process in the diffusion of socio-environmental innovation in the RENDRUS network. It means that more information about best practices and new technology corresponds to less uncertainty on rural producer perceptions about relative advantage, compatibility and complexity of innovations, creating better conditions to the emergence and adaptation.